In this video, I'm going to show you how you can download the audio and video for your live streams so you can repurpose it really easily. But before we do that, let's roll the intro.
My name is Rob Balasabas.
Hey! If you've been following me on Facebook or YouTube or LinkedIn or even Twitter, you'll know that I go live probably anywhere from 2 to 4 times each week, usually interviewing other experts in my space. Unlike a lot of live streamers out there, my work with that piece of live stream content doesn't end once I stop broadcasting. I download a copy of that live stream video and audio, and I repurpose it to promote that content on other channels, even after the live stream has been completed. So in this really quick tutorial, I'm gonna show you how you can download your audio and video using Streamyard really easily. And also at the end of this video, I'm gonna share 3 ways so you can easily repurpose the video and audio replay so that you can continue to get traction on that piece of content even after the live stream is done. So let's go jump into my screen. All right, so welcome to my screen. Again, this is Streamyard. So if you wanna get started with using Streamyard, just go into the description, click on that link. Again, it's an affiliate link, so I do appreciate your support for this channel. Also, if you wanna learn how to use Streamyard to go live, you can click on this little link right here that's gonna be popping up in the pop-out right above me. This is my Streamyard dashboard. What you'll find here is the broadcast link right above, all my upcoming broadcasts right here. As you can see, I've got broadcasts that are scheduled ahead of time. And again, this is something you can do on Streamyard. You can live stream on multiple channels, Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, even Twitter through Periscope directly on Streamyard. For example, you'll see this one right here that's gonna be happening tomorrow, which is gonna be going live to multiple Facebook pages and groups, LinkedIn, my personal LinkedIn Live, YouTube, and also Periscope. So you can do that all here. But for this tutorial, I wanna show you guys how you can easily download a live stream that's already happened. So once you've logged in to Streamyard, what you wanna do is you wanna go to past broadcasts up here. So you'll see that menu. And here is a list of past broadcasts that I have done. As you can see, I've done quite a fair bit. I can actually load more. There's actually more to this and I can keep on scrolling. But what you wanna do if you wanna download your audio and video recording of a previous live stream is just click on the more drop down on the right hand side here. So this one that I just did, actually, I believe earlier today, I just click on more on the drop down here. And right away, you see at the bottom of the menu, download recording. So I'm gonna click on that. And it allows me the option to download the recording, which includes the audio and video, or download the audio only. So I'm gonna do the recording so that I get both audio and video. All right, so now it has actually started to download, and you can see that kind of right here at the bottom left of my screen. And while we are here, it's really important to note that Streamyard will only save your recordings for 7 days. So that being said, make sure that you put it into your workflow that after you do your live stream, you download a copy of your recording. So that is how that works. All right, perfect. So now it has completed its download, so I can go ahead and open this up and see this in the Finder, in my file manager. Okay, so I see it here in my file manager. I'm just gonna open it up. I just put it on mute so that it doesn't conflict with my audio recording here, but you can see my replay is ready to go, ready to be edited for repurposing, and that is how you do that. All right, hopefully that tutorial was helpful for you. Like I said, here are the 3 ways that you can repurpose your audio and video from a live stream so that you can continue to drive views and engagement to previous live streams that you've already done. First one is IGTV. Take the video and put it up on IGTV. You can also take a little snippet of the live stream interview, maybe one highlight from the interview where you delivered a really valuable tip or advice, and put it up on IGTV. The nice thing about IGTV is that you can put a clickable link. No matter how many followers you have on Instagram, you can put a clickable link to either the YouTube video or maybe Facebook where you have the entire full length interview on IGTV. The second place is LinkedIn. Now, if you're not uploading video natively to LinkedIn, then you are missing out on a huge opportunity. LinkedIn right now loves video content. So I would suggest taking that same highlight that you put on IGTV and uploading it to LinkedIn as a natively uploaded video. After a while, you will find that LinkedIn will continue to actually help you serve that video to your audience. You're going to continue to get more reach using an uploaded video directly to LinkedIn. And the third tip for repurposing your live stream replays, now that you have the audio file, you can actually create a podcast. You can edit the audio version of your live stream replay and actually take out the beginning part and get to the interview aspect and upload that as a podcast interview. You can also record a very short introduction. You can say, "Hey guys, it's Rob here. Welcome to this episode of this podcast. In this interview that I held a couple days ago, I talked to David and we talked about X, Y, and Z. Enjoy this interview." And then again, it's another way where you are repurposing the live stream content that you just did with your guest or by yourself and put it in an audio version on a podcast to reach a new audience. And there you have it. Hopefully that was helpful. Again, you can find all the links to getting started on Streamyard down in the description. Thank you for supporting this channel. Make sure you hit subscribe, hit that notification bell as well. And also check out these next videos. The first one is how to go live on YouTube without using OBS, using Streamyard really easily. And then the other video here that you can choose is a tutorial where you can learn how to multi-stream to multiple channels, up to 5 channels at once, using Streamyard, and I show you that in this tutorial. So enjoy the next videos, and I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.